Holy Spirit, have your way, have your way, oh Lord, in my life, have your way, oh Lord. Holy Spirit, have your way, have your way, oh Lord, in my life, have your way, oh Lord. Holy Spirit, have your way, have your way, oh Lord, in my life, have your way, oh Lord. Amen. Wherever you are, I want you to open your mouth loud and clear and pray this prayer. Holy Spirit of the living God, minister the word of God into my life in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit of the living God, minister the word of God into my life in the name of Jesus. Minister the word of God into my life in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we come to your presence, O Lord. Father, open our understanding in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, teach us your word in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Children of God, we are looking at the world. When you miss heaven, you cannot miss air. When you miss heaven, you cannot miss air. Brethren, we are in the market and we shall return back home one day. Whether you like, use 100 years. If you like, pray that you want to break the record of Methuselah, that you want to live long, but one day you will leave this sinful world. The most important thing in life is our destination. After everything in this world, where are we heading to? This is the question that we need to ask ourselves. Brethren, let us open our Bible to the book of Matthew, chapter 7, verse 13. Book of Matthew, chapter 7, verse 13 to 14. Enter ye in at the strait gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that lead to destruction, and many there be which go in their hearts. Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. Brethren, this is the word of the Lord. We have two straight gates. One is wide and broad. One is narrow. Children of God, this is two road. One is wide and broad that leads to destruction, while the second one is narrow, which lead unto life. Brethren, our Lord Jesus Christ talk about two road that leads to two different places: the straight and narrow road that leads to heaven, and the wide and broad road that leads to hell. Everyone is on one of these two roads, and everyone will go to one of these two destinations. The question that we need to ask ourselves: where are we heading to? Heaven or hell? Children of God, heaven is real, hell is real. In the book of John, chapter 14, verse 2, Jesus said, "In my Father's house are many mansions. It were not so, I would not have told you. I go to prepare a place for you." It's a place prepared for you and I. Children of God, this is where Jesus is. I want you to know, as a children of God, our focus should be on heaven. There was a day, a young girl looked at the sky and he saw stars and he said, if heaven is this beautiful on this side, how beautiful must it be on the other side? Our Lord Jesus Christ has confirmed to us that heaven is real. He's telling us it's a wonderful place for us to be. When we get to heaven, we are going to see the eternity. We are going to see the place that the Lord Jesus has prepared for those who love him, for those who are faithful. Children of God, there are a lot of people who does not believe that hell is real also. Children of God, I want us to open our Bible to the book of Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 9. The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? Children of God, there are Lord, they don't believe in hell. They don't believe in the truth. Hell is a place of torment. It's a place of suffering. It's a place that has been prepared for Satan and his angels, the fallen angels. Hell is a place of darkness and it's a place of fire. Wherever you are, I want you to shout loud and clear and pray this prayer. Anything in my life that will make heaven far from me, jump out of me now in the name of Jesus. Anything in my life that will make heaven far from me, jump out now in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Anything in my life that will make heaven far from me, jump out now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Brethren, we have two roads now. Which one are you on? The road that is narrow or the road that is broad? Brethren, our Lord Jesus Christ has shown us the way. Straight is the gate and narrow is the way which lead unto life. Brethren, Jesus has bought the ticket to heaven for you. The high time has come. I want you to know, heaven is for people who are saved, but hell for people who are not saved. Many Christians today, we have lost focus. We allow the things of this world to carry us away. The purpose that we have come into this world is to run the race and end up in heaven. But today, we are doing other things. Nowadays, the love of money has taken away many people. Selfishness, lukewarmness. Today you are cold, tomorrow you are hot. Civilization, we allow that to carry us. Lust of appetite for the word of God. We no longer read the word of God. Many people today, we have neglected the word of God. We are after self-pleasure. It is high time for us to come back. For Bible make us to understand, in the book of Romans chapter 3 verse 23, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The truth is, everyone is guilty. Don't be a civilized Christian. Many people today no longer go to church for church program. What they say, after all, technology has made it easier to serve God. I want you to know, don't neglect or forsake the gathering of saints. This is the word of God. It is high time to come back to God. For Bible make us understand, in the book of Proverbs, chapter 14, verse 12, there is a way that seems right to a man, but its end is the way of death. Its end is the way of destruction. It is high time to come back to God. Don't allow the buying and selling in the market of life to make you to end up in hell. I pray hell will not be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Children of God, heaven will be full of happy people, but hell is for people who never happy again. Are you ready to enjoy the place that the Lord Jesus Christ has prepared for you? And Paul the apostle was longing to leave this world and go to heaven. He said, I am hard pressed between the two, having a desire to depart and be with Christ, which is far better. Nevertheless, to remain in the flesh is more needful for you, for our citizenship is in heaven. from which we also eagerly wait for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Brethren, are you listening under the sound of my voice? I want you to know our home will either be heaven or hell. We need to prepare ourselves. We will make the choice. The choice is us as to where we are going. If one is not prepared to go to heaven, he will end up in hell. Our number one goal in this life must be for heaven, to be at home, to be where Jesus Christ has prepared for us. No one will accidentally go to heaven. Finally, brethren, if you don't make heaven, your life has been a complete waste. When I miss heaven, I miss all. I pray for you, wherever you are, you will not miss heaven in the mighty name of Jesus. Peradventure, you have given your life to Jesus Christ and you are backslided, or you have not given your life to Jesus Christ at all, but you want to give your life to Jesus Christ right now. I want you to open your mouth wherever you are, children of God, and say after me. Lay your right hand on your chest and say, Father, I come before you now. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Take control of my life. As from today, I say bye-bye to the devil. I enter into the kingdom of light. In the name of Jesus. Amen. I congratulate us wherever we are. Children of God, let us open our mouth and begin to confess all our sins. That Father, forgive me, Lord. Father, forgive me, Lord. Every area of my life that I have sinned against thee. Father, forgive me. If you have given your life to Jesus Christ before, but you backslided, open your mouth and begin to ask for the mercy of God. Father, have mercy upon my life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, have mercy, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are forgiven. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Lord Jesus. Lord Almighty, King of Glory, I call upon you, Lord. For as many that has given their life to Jesus Christ, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, save them, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Because it is written in the book of Romans chapter 10 verse 13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Father, in the name of Jesus, save each and every soul that has surrendered their life to you, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Brethren, wherever you are, have you ever dreamed of rapture before and you notice that you are not rapturable? Brethren, immediately you notice it. When you wake up from that dream, you are now crying. Children of God, I know you will cry, but you don't need to cry. You need to thank God for your life. It's not everybody that have the opportunity to see that vision, to see that revelation, to have that kind of dream. For you to have that kind of dream is a warning to you. For you to amend your way, you need to ask God, the Father, have mercy, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. I want you to open your mouth and shout loud and clear. You will mention your name. I, Owolabi Onaola, will not miss heaven in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. I, Owolabi Onaola, will not miss heaven in the name of Jesus. I will not miss heaven in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus. Daddy, we thank you for your word. Glory be to your holy name in the name of Jesus. Lord, we call upon you. Have mercy, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Anything in our life that we make heaven not to be happy with us, Father, Lord, in the name of Jesus, let those things jump out of our life in the mighty name of Jesus. At the end of everything in this world, we shall make heaven in the name of Jesus. We shall shout hallelujah in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Ancient of Days. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. You are welcome to Midnight Prayer Point Channel. the channels where we pray like mad. God bless you in the